Small story behind me chasing these technologies is just to see that make engineers' life easy. You can sleep well. Otherwise, it's always a nightmare, especially when you're a leader. You don't know what happens at site. Nothing is under control. So this has been a challenge for each and every builder. And we are not really able to do something about it to make our life easy. So this is where I thought, bring something, some technologies where the human errors doesn't creep into your practice of construction, right from your designing. Nowadays the errors can creep in, and it leads to a big disaster. So I'm sure a lot of us as engineers on field, we have sleepless nights because nothing is under your control. So what do you do to bring something is under your control? Where you don't expect somebody to make, think and take some decision on site, which will be right or wrong, but which pains you. So try to see that the human errors which gets into, which creep in, knowing we are unknowingly doing construction. That is the reason why I start of introducing technologies, looking for technologies. And secondly, it was a challenge. As a passion, I took a decision that the best of the world's technology has to be offered for the most underprivileged people's construction, that is a mass housing. But normally we call it as low cost, even today it is tagged as low cost. Low cost not necessarily be a low quality construction. It can be a very high quality, the best of the Indian or the international standards. And that's what we have been able to achieve today. And that's what I'm going to share with you, whatever I have done. 3-4 years back, I had an opportunity to present about monolithic construction technology, which was for first ever. So we were fairly able to break the history of the cycle time in construction. Almost every 48 hours, even today, we have been able to make 4 houses with a mount. Every 48 hours, we have a 4-house shell ready. So in 2 days, we can make 4 houses. That is the speed at which we are doing. Probably in aluminium former, even today, I have not heard the 48 hour cycle in India. So these are the potential of these technologies. Next, we move on to precast. As a next level of improvement on the technology, again, these monolithic constructions have something left on the site to be decided, something to be done on the site. At least about 60% of the work, or say 80% of the work, has to be done on site. So this precast is something where you do 80% of the work in a controlled environment inside a factory, and 20% of the work will be doing on site. So all your overheads on the site would be your engineering overheads, labor overheads, the establishments, everything comes down when you get into such technologies. So with this, let me start my presentation. Of course, precast, you know what it is. It is done in a controlled environment. Those buildings where majority of structural components are standardized. That's very important, standardization. The most important thing, what I feel, if you want to think about technology, one element is from our rate analysis has to be removed, which is most commonly and widely accepted, that is wastage. If you remove wastage, then your thinking will be smart. You will find all your ways to do something innovative so that you don't do wastage in construction. 5 to 10% of wastage is, it is normal and very royally accepted in any of your data analysis. The moment you stop it. My experience of using these technologies, the wastages are in decimals. 0.2, 0.3, 0.5. Not even that. That is what I observed in on-site constructions. There are two kinds of precast constructions you can think. The volumetric, that is a cube mold, where you construct the whole module in the factory and take the whole module and erect it. And the second is your panel, 2D constructions. It's just plain panels and which are manufactured to your size and then taken onto the site and erect it. advantages, everybody knows about it. What kind of advantages? Excellent finish, excellent quality. Your life is made easy on site. Nothing else. Just the balance on the site. Take the balance, put them, ground. Not a rocket science. It is just building your sidestone basin. You take two good trust sidestones, keep it aside. Only thing is, we are connecting with it block to block with some reinforcement and structural designs. And then you are filling those joints. You used to sit with the mortar. It will be filling because the height of the joint is more. It will be just filling with the free flow curve. That's it. Otherwise, all the structural details and other things regarding precast fillings. Some of the other, you can look at the finish of this ceiling. It is unplastered surface. If you use this kind of hollow or slabs, you can go up to 10 meters, 15 meters span without intermediate supports. Structures can be designed, especially commercial buildings. You can, it's very easy. So this is how we started thinking on precasting. The challenge in India is we don't have very good access roads to all the projects. That's has been a challenge in India. Of course, when I started, it was still a challenge. So you can't carry a very big element on the road, onto the site, and start erecting it. So I thought it could be better. You have a facility on the site. So I've designed it in such a way that this entire roof structure is completely, it could be a knockdown structure. You can just remove it in 15 days and re-erect it in 15 days. The entire facility can be removed and re-erected in a maximum of 45 days. You are ready for the product. That is the only lead time you need. By the time you finish all your designs and other things, this can fit in. So it is very simple. And you see lot of complicated things, complicated equipment. Of course, I did study on that when I went to the other countries to see what is precasting to understand. Finally, I got it to this level where people were talking about multiple floors, 10 floors, 15 floors, 50 floors of investment on precast. We could bring it down to our conditions. I'll show you how we do it. Almost in about 6 to 7 crores of investment, you'll be able to create an entire facility precast with about 10 to 15 tables, which can produce about 450 to 500 square meters of elements every day in one shift. If you want to make two shifts, you can double it. Well, these are called the pallets. It is just a table. The pallets are nothing but a table with a high precision, with a single sheet of 12 meters by 4.5 meters. That's the size of the pallets we have imported. It's from Germany. So, there's no joint, seamless. That was a challenge in India to get these kind of full length sheets without any joint for 4.5 meters by 12 meters. Nowadays, I think it's the carpet manufacturing in India. So, the advantage of this is, unlike any formwork construction, every time when you change the design of a structure, you need to make lot of change into your formwork system. Here, since you are playing only with the 2D elements, your formwork is very, very, very minimum changes. Say, a project of about 25-30 crores, project, if it is the value of the project, the formwork would hardly cost you around 5 to 8 lakhs. And if you manage to reuse and recycle, it could be even less. So that is the kind of investment that gets into formwork mounts. Because it is just only side mounts what you are going to do, and rest of it, it just continues. So that's one thing, the biggest advantage. See, this is the mount. If you want an element, about 6 meters, say about 3 meters, 6 meters by 3 meters, this size, and you have windows, you just put some inserts. You have any beam openings, put some inserts. This is the kind of formwork you need. This is a fan, it's about 6 meters length and about 3 meters in height. It has two window openings. And you can just look at the reinforcement details. It's a two-layer mesh on both the faces of the, it's a wall element, both faces of the wall. And these are, what you see is, they are called double tubes, where it connects from one vertical element to the next vertical element. So there will be double bars which are coming from the bottom vertical element, and you just insert the third pass into this tubes and then drop it. So it becomes just one single element as per the structural designs we need to do. Again, these are some of the details. It's on the pallet we have placed. This is the kind of formwork we need. It could be in plywood if you have any less limitation. It could be in steel if you have more limitations. And these are the kind of magnets which has a capacity between 2 to 4 tons. And because it is steel, you can't nail the table and other things. You just fix these magnets and lock it to the formwork so that it just stays intact. These are simple pour buckets. Otherwise, the proposal normally is to have a concrete spreader. According to me, as I have seen it, it costs in few lakhs, maybe 20, 30, it goes up to a crore, depending on the energization they use outside. This hardly costs about 30,000 rupees or 40,000 rupees. You have a bucket which can be mounted on a crane and it goes all the directions, x and y direction, picks up the concrete, comes and pours. So just come, pour the concrete. Again, they used to use table wide vendors, which we avoided. Everything I saw that it comes to an affordable price and to our condition, where whatever equipment you are using, you just try to deploy and use it in the past. It's just a simple table wide vendor we used. In the next stage, how do you finish it? Regular our floaters. Otherwise, there was a proposal for a helicopter finish, which again, nearly 90 to 100 lakhs if you want the important use. Most importantly, they are all stationary tables what we have used. Otherwise, the concept outside is to see that the table moves and all activity happens only in one table, concreting, rebar, it is finished and pushed. So we didn't go for that system, we went for those plain stationary tables. Very simple, very easy and cost effective. And this is the kind of finish at the end you get after the float, you just have to do a hand finish. This is a finished product. Just trim the edges, after that clean it and lay it. We are going to demount it after about 12 hours. You will use a concrete which can attain a strength of 10 to 12 MPa in 12 hours. So that your cycle time is maintained. After 12 hours you demount it and you start lifting it. Again for lifting, they use what is called as a tilting table, which again costs too much. It may vary something between somewhere about 18, 20 lakhs. If it is mechanized, it goes up to 80 lakhs. So we didn't do that. We started lifting these elements horizontally first. And we had just a reclined bed where we took it and reclined it. When it comes to your position, you lift it. So the entire cost of that machine is avoided. These are the bounds for the staircase. We have done 100% precast. We have not used any element in masonry, no plaster, no masons. This is the kind of finish you get in the staircase. It's almost what you draw in the drawing. This is the kind of elements used to manufacture, and each element is numbered, its history, everything is given so that any problems anywhere on when it is transported, you will be able to track it. Any problem you will be able to address it, and look at the badge, what was the problem. This is a stock yard. The entire width and length of the factory was about 180 meters by 22 meters, wherein we have a complete stock yard, production yard, and these are the sprinkler arrangements we did. Once you pump the water, it just sprinkles. As many of you are the landscape, we just use that arrangement. After lifting, it plays in the yard. And this is the kind of dovels we leave from one floor. And you take the element, insert it onto the dovel, grout it. Now the element is ready. Whatever the holes you see here, they're the double tubes. And your reinforcement has already entered these levels. So just make a fine ground and make it flow so that your core joint can actually sustain. The ground is being poured. In slab, what we did, because joints are always an upper tension in precast, so no horizontal joints. We went for a partly precast element for the slab so that your finishes are achieved. And the rest is in situ screening. That's the only inside screening we used to do. It's about 75 mm of precast and 75 mm of screen. That was the whole slab, no horizontal joints. Wall to wall is a vertical joint. This is the section we have written. This is one wall element, another wall element. There are some loop joints where you have right hand side biases also from both the elements. And you insert a reinforcement into it, and this entire area is just grouted. If you need, you can put cements here, or you can go for any other finishing grouts which are available in the market. This is where we come for the project now.